Rain on the Roof. We are going to read a beautiful poem by Coates Kinney, that is Rain on the Roof. Now, if I ask you one simple question, do you love rain? Nowadays, it has been raining for 2 days. So, how much you love rain? Or whenever you see rain, what comes to your mind? Tell me, children.
Ma'am, greenery.
Greenery, very good. And what comes to your mind? You all love rain. Rainy season is actually in Patna, because of water logging and other problems, we don't like rain. But basically, rain is actually, we all know it's water. Okay? Prakhar, even I love rain, but not flood. That I all agree. Whenever we see flood, deluge, or any kind of water logging in any of the area, or excessive rain is destroying anything, then we don't love it. Because nowadays, because of this vast storm, so many farmers, their entire cultivation, you know what happened? They actually had a lot of problems. So definitely at that time, we don't appreciate rain. We don't love rain. But rain is actually what? It's a beautiful moment. It's a beautiful season also. If we have the enough rain, which is important for our requirement, because water is elixir of life. We cannot imagine a single day without water. So rain is actually a medium which brings life to the entire people, entire humanity, and all the living creatures. But still, poets, they have used rain in their own manner. If you will go through some beautiful poems by Wordsworth, Shelley, then you will really, they are the great poets, okay? Romantic poets, they have romance with nature, and they have explained rain in their own way, okay? That rain, how nice it looks and how beautiful it looks. Even Hindi poets, they have also explained rain in their own way. In the movies also, you would have seen that so many songs are there based on rain and rainy season. So that is the importance of rain. Now, here in this poem, what is that rain on the roof? What happened with the poet? Why he is missing? Whom he is missing? You know, this poem is actually very emotional. Why? Because whenever you have lost something, or maybe you are a little annoyed, or maybe you are going through some difficult phase of your life, you want some relaxation, you want solace. And where did you get? Two places you will always find in your life. One is nature. Nature has a strong healing power, okay? And second is, obviously, second not. In fact, I should have said that first, that your mother. Mother always gives you that cozy atmosphere, her cuddle, her love, her, affection, okay? That then you really feel secure whenever you are with your mother. So you can never ever forget that if maybe you are away from your mother due to any of the reasons, your mommy, you will always miss her. So here in this poem, you are going to see that how nature feels and how poet feels comfortable whenever he is recollecting those old memories. Okay, he's recollecting because he wanted to remember those lovely moments which he had spent with his mother. So he's recollecting those memories. And how he is able to remember those memories? Because pitter patter of the raindrops. The rainy season has started, and that gentle, shower of rain, it actually made him remember those lovely days when he was with his mother, and lovely, feelings, that emotion. So you are definitely going to be emotional with this poem when you will go through the entire one. Rain on the Roof. So let's begin the poem. Coates Kinney. He is the poet of this beautiful poem, Rain on the Roof. He was actually an American lawyer, politician, journalist, and obviously a poet. You are going to love this piece because in this poem, the poet expresses his love for nature and praises the healing power of rain, especially when heard from a cozy bed in a very sweet, lovely cottage. The poet is actually excited, thrilled, when he observes the starry sky being overshadowed by the rain-bearing clouds. But yeah, you will find out that he does not like the darkness that spreads all around. Okay, and so he feels that when the sky is covered with dark clouds and it starts raining, have you ever listened to the patter of soft rain on the roof? Yeah, we all have listened. In fact, we have known the magic of that music. Okay, because these are the natural music. We are only listening artificial music all the time. But if you ever get an opportunity to go to a nice, place which is filled with natural, resources, you can say, trees, chirping of birds, there you will really feel that natural music. Because, fine, we are actually playing music through different musical instruments, but who is better than God and his natural creatures? You know, that chirping of birds, different type of voices when they are actually taking out. You will definitely feel happy. So if you ever get an opportunity, just go to those places and enjoy everything, that strong, essence of nature. Here you will also go through that what poet is thinking. What thoughts flashed through your mind as you heard this melody of nature? Yeah, nature can be so melodious that definitely so many things will come to your mind. And when I ask you that why you love rain, you say greenery. Because green color is color of life. And definitely we want to go there. We want to go to a park. We want to go to a jungle. We want to go to those places, hilly areas, where we can see, we can witness, we can feel nature. So that through this poem, the poet also wanted to convey the same. Okay? We can make out that poem is definitely about the rain on the roof. Means the entire poem will revolve around rain. Because poet is telling us about the memories he has of the rain. What type of memories? Rain memories, those lovely memories, sweet memories, which is also related to his past. Past means when he was fortunate to be with his mother. Okay, so that is why I told you that this poem is very emotional. Because when you will go through those poems, then you will find out how emotionally we all are attached to our mother and how badly we miss them when we are not with them, because they are very close to our heart. Nowadays, you might not be missing her because since you have the privilege to be with her, but very soon when you will go somewhere for your higher studies, for your job, then you are going to miss your mother badly. You will remember each and every moment which you shared with her, okay, which you spent with her. And if any memory that is connected with any particular season, then definitely you will remember it. And these nature, this natural object will also make you, remind you the days which you have passed with them, the days which you have spent with them, okay? So now look at the lines carefully. When the humid shadows hover over all the starry spheres and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears, what a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. Now, first of all, I will explain you word meanings. Humid, which is full of moisture. Now here, humid shadows refers to, write down, moisture-laden clouds. Humid shadows, that means moisture-laden clouds, okay? Which is going to rain very soon. Hover move around something. Helicopter hovers. Then one new word for you, my dear children, melancholy. Melancholy means sad, gloom, sad. Bliss. Bliss means happiness. Blessings and bliss. Patter, pitter patter. These are the sounds of raindrops falling on the roof. And cottage chamber means comfortable chamber. Chamber here is referring to the bedroom. The bedroom, the place where the poet is lying. Okay? So all the words are clear. Now look at the lines. The poet wants to convey this, that when the humid shadows hover, humid shadows, full, as I told you, this means moisture-laden clouds. Also means moisture-laden, if the clouds are having a lot of moisture, it looks dark. No, so dark is dark clouds, which is full of water. So the poet is saying, when the dark clouds are full of water and it is hovering, it is actually hovering, moving in the sky. And when this sky is full of these clouds, which is obviously dark, moisture laden, full of water, so definitely they are about to bring the rain, and it is moving there in the sky. Then what happens? Overall, the starry spheres. Starry means here stars. This refers to the sky at night, which is full of stars. Starry spheres means the sky which is full of stars. So chandni, taro se bhari hui raat. Ab taro se bhari hui raat mein achanak kya ho jata hai? Ye kaale badal aa jate hain. And then they cover the entire sky. Okay? So this twinkling stars now is behind these moisture-laden dark clouds. And the sky is covered with these clouds. And what happens? Obviously, when the sky will be covered with these clouds, rain will start. So this dark clouds, they have covered the entire sky, the sky which was till now filled with twinkling stars. Okay? And when it happened, at that time, these huge clouds, which are obviously full of moisture, they started moving around in the sky. Then what happens? The melancholy darkness. There is melancholy. So the entire place becomes gloomy, sad. Yeah, darkness ko thoda melancholy kar diya hai, udaas ho jati hai. Obviously, twinkling stars, they are, the sky is full, filled with, you know, dark clouds. And then there is what? There is a gloomy darkness. There is very sad darkness. Gloomy darkness. So then thereafter what happens? What poet wants to convey? Gently weeps in rainy tears. And when it all happens, then what happened? The raindrops, pitter-patter raindrops, started falling from the sky. How? Like tears of rain. Now tears, ye kiske tears hai? These tears are, these raindrops are compared to tears. Maybe that dark, you know, clouds, they are separated with the water, the moisture. So perhaps because of this separation, they are shedding their tears. You know, kyunki barish kisse alag ho raha hai? Clouds se. And perhaps for that reason, the cloud is shedding tears. So that is why the poet wants to convey that this night is white, but is still gently weeps in rainy tears. This melancholy darkness, what happens during this moment? That the raindrop, which appears to be like tears falling from the sky. Now everything is negative, okay? And poet is comparing raindrops to tears because maybe the dark sky is very sad. It is a gloomy, melancholy darkness. Maybe because these raindrops are coming out of the clouds and cloud is being separated with that moisture. Whatever is happening. But all of a sudden, during this entire gloomy situation, in this sad environment, although he's feeling very nice, poet says that, yes, I am genuinely feeling, you know, very relaxed. How? That he feels that it is like a blessing. What a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed. Oh, what a bliss. It's a blessing to lie on the bed in his cottage chamber, in his bedroom, and lie listening and listening to the pitter patter of the raindrops falling on the roof, falling softly overhead. Overhead here means on the roof. So, oh, I know, although the things are very, you know, negative, things are very sad, but still one good thing had happened to me, that I genuinely feel relaxed. Why? Because I'm listening. What am I listening? The pitter-patter, the soft rain falling on my roof, which is actually making a very melodious sound. And that is actually the music of nature. And I really feel happy. I really feel blessed. Why he is feeling so blessed? Although he says it's melancholy, the dark clouds had covered the sky. That you will come to know in next and then in the final paragraph. Now he says, every tinkle, tinkle, you know, short ringing sound, tinkling, on the singles. Singles means the wooden tiles which is used on roof. Basically tiles malo roof ka. So every tinkle on the singles has an echo in the heart. Echo, you know, kunjana, repeated sound. And a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start. Okay? Busy being means human beings. Basically, he is referring to himself, busy being start. And a thousand recollections weave their air threads into woof as I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof. Now, woof here means woof, actually, roof or woof, it is a poetic license. In order to bring rhythm to the poem, the poets are allowed to, you know, twist the, you can say, words. Okay? And that is why woof. Woof here means weft. That is thread woven across the loom. Let us weave karna. Weave ko isne woof mein kar diya. Air threads pe binna. Okay? Now, why poet is feeling so relaxed? Why he is saying that it is a blessing to lie in your cottage chamber and then to listen this sweet, soft pitter patter of the raindrops, which is falling so softly on your roof and bringing a melody to your ears. Okay? Why? The poet is expressing his feelings that when he listens the raindrops falling on the rooftop of his house, he simply want to say that every tinkle, every this ringing sound on the tiles, wooden tiles, has an echo in the heart. Okay, what does it mean? That whenever this sound is coming, it is repeating in his heart, in his dream. And it has sound, it has many different fanciful imagination. What happens? Actually, it is reminding me. It is recollecting those old memories. Well, so my busy being, that means in the mind of me, a human being, thousand dreamy fancies, thousand fanciful stories, imagination, those lovely, you know, memories of old days is started. Okay? And he simply adds that the sound of the rain falling on the rooftop create many, many new different dreams in his mind. Means a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start. And the thousand recollections means he started recollecting, okay, many memories of the past. which come back to his mind as a dreamy fancies, as a dreamy imagination. And so he says that when he listens to the patter of the rain upon the roof, he has many new dreams in the mind, and he started weaving binna ek ek cheez ko dhaagon se gunta hai yaadon ke dhaagon se. So he started remembering those dreamy fancies, the memories of past started coming back to him, and he started remembering those moments. What? The past memories, the old days, those lovely memories. What type of memories it was when he was ab yahan pe aaoge, what type of memories the poet is going to recollect. Okay, so till now it is clear. Now in memories comes my mother. Jab bhi past ki baat aap karoge, and if you are unfortunate, if it's because of whatever reason, okay, you are not with your mother, then the very first thing, if you remember your childhood days, and unfortunately you are not with your mother due to various reasons, a time will come in our life when we all have to be separated with our loved ones. That is the truth. That is the reality of this picture for. Maybe at that moment, you all will remember. So first of all, what comes to his mind? See, now in memory comes my mother, as she used in years agone to regard the darling dreamers. Or here means it's an old poetic word. So E-R-E here means, pull it low, before. Or is actually referring before. Before she left them till the dawn. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I listen to this refrain. Refrain means a repeated part of poem or sound. Listen, children, tomorrow I am going to explain you literary devices. I think I haven't explained you all the literary devices, no? And then again, I will explain you this point. Anyway, which is played upon the singers by the patter of the rain. First of all, let me explain you these lines. Now the poet is introducing his mother to the readers. Now he is coming back to that. He is introducing his mother to whom? To us. That what type of memory is coming to his mind? Which memory he is, or which lovely memory he is recollecting? Yes, my dear children, he is remembering about his mother. He says that he is dreaming of his mother. And he has told in the, in the previous stanza, we all have seen that when he says, rain brings memories of the past. So what past? Which past? Actually, it is the memory of his mother, obviously, perhaps, who is no longer alive. Or maybe, I will not tell you exactly that how and whether he is separated or maybe she is no more. But yeah, we can assume that he is not with his mother. Perhaps she is no longer alive, or perhaps she is somewhere else. Anyway, so he remembered that in the past, mother, she obviously loved their children. She used to, and that's why she says that she used to consider her children darling dreamers. Yeah, darling dreamers has been referred to him and his siblings, uske bhai behno ke liye hai. She used to consider him darling, you know, lovable, and she would let him sleep till daybreak and have sweet dreams. So what was she doing? That she was coming to bid them good night, to give them a good night kiss. She was coming to their rooms, okay, before she was going to sleep till the dawn. So she was keeping, the poet can feel that how mother, before going to bed, before retiring to bed, she used to come to their room where she was putting her babies, poet, and other children, her his siblings, to bed, and she was bidding good night, kissing them good night kiss, asking his darling dreamers, darling, it is referred for poet and for his siblings. And dreamers, because children now they are sleeping, that means they are dreaming, they are in a dreamy state. So before going to bed, मालूम की आदत होती है ना माँ जो होती है अपने बच्चों को अगर दूसरे रूम में सोए हैं तो गुड नाइट बोलने आएगी. Anything, whatever you require, she will come to say, okay, now sleep, tomorrow we will meet. So before retiring to her bed, she was coming to that room and maybe kissing them, looking after them, bidding goodbye to her darling, to her children, those who are now going to sleep, they are going to dream. So now he sees, oh, I feel her fond look on me. As I list here means listen to this refrain. The poet can still feel that his mother is looking at him as he listens. List for listens. Listens to the song, to the raindrops, or you can say the music, to the melody that raindrops is bringing to him by falling on the rooftop of his room. Okay? So he says that the poet, that is why the poet is moved, touched by the sound of the raindrops on the singles of his room. Because whenever he listens to this sound, it brings back memories of the past, and specifically the memories which is related to his mother. You know, the memories which is related to his mother. So he says that I know she is not with me now, but still I'm able to remember those lovely days when she was coming to our room, bidding us good night, and so I still feel her fond look. I still can imagine her eyes on me, why, who is actually reminding me of those memories? Yes, these memories are coming back to me whenever I listen to the pitter patter of these raindrops. So basically these memories are coming back to me. Okay, now poem is clear. Once again, I will repeat it, don't worry. Now see, first of all, see the literary devices in the poem. Stanza 1, we have so many alliterations. Humid hover, starry spheres, press pillow, lie listening. Okay, we have one interesting, you know, figure of a speech. Onomatopoeia, the sound denoting words. Pitter patter of raindrops. So patter word is onomatopoeia. Then we have personification, because darkness has been personified when he says melancholy darkness. So darkness has been personified. Now move to stanza 2. Alliteration again, busy bee, deathbed, rain roof. Okay, once again we have onomatopoeia, tinkle, patter. Personification, recollection is personified when he says that he eats dreams. Stanza 3, we have alliteration, memory, my mother, darling dreamers. We have onomatopoeia, patter, sound of raindrops falling on the singles on the roof. So that is onomatopoeia. Then we have one interesting, you know, literary device also, transferred epithet. That means the use of an adjective with a noun when it is referring to another noun. So melancholy darkness, that is also personification where darkness has been personified, but melancholy darkness. The darkness is not melancholy, but it refers to the sad people. Because if, so see, the meaning has been transferred. And that is why this darkness is not melancholy. It is about the sad people. That whenever there is dark clouds in the sky, it makes people sad. Okay? We have also dreamy fancies, dreamy fancy, it is also a kind of transferred epithet, because adjective is a noun which is refers to another noun. That means dreamy fancies. It does not mean that the fancies are dreamy, but refers to the people who have dreams. Okay, so we have these many literary devices. Okay, so as finally you all have seen that how poet has varied recollections of the sound of raindrops falling on the roof of his house, and how this memory, this melody of this music is bringing back those sweet memories of the past. He says that the sound of raindrops helps him fall asleep and gives him sweet dreams. What type of sweet dreams? When he was actually with his mother, he has memory of his loving mother who would put them to sleep and who would put her darling dreamers to sleep. So whenever he is listening to this pitter patter of raindrops, this music, this melody is bringing back those lovely memories of his childhood. And obviously, childhood memories, that is related, definitely it will always be related to your mother. And in this manner, the poet is being a little nostalgic. He is missing those lovely days and he wants to get back to them. But anyway, it is not possible. So he is simply trying to refer, you know, recollect those lovely memories.